everyone. So let's get started. I'm gonna do my eyebrows first. I'm using Milani. It's actually eyeshadow, but I use it for my eyebrows. A little brush. I wish that this makeup was a little bit more either powdery or liquidy, kind of in the middle right now. Weird. So let's go ahead and fill these eyebrows in. One look to the other. My eyebrows are super thin on the end. It took me a long time to figure out how to do my eyebrows because of the fact that, like, they're not even. I don't know, it's really hard to do. Anyway, so let's skip forward. The eyebrows are taken care of. Kind of. So I guess next we can do our eyes, which I'm gonna do it. It's really basic with the Naked palette. Basic eyes. That one, and probably I have barely any left if y'all can see that. There's nothing really in there. But I'm gonna try to get something out of it. Or I'll use the next one up, which is just like pink. Alright, so let's get our corner and our other corner. I should start out with two dots just so I kind of know where everything is going. Let me get. Sorry y'all, I have all my makeup in a bag. I was doing makeup earlier and I didn't feel like putting anything away in the first place. I'm using a blending brush, I guess. Just blend all this until and then do the same thing with this side. Blend it until it's like undetectable. You want there to be no real edges. See how this side, it took almost all of it out with blending? I'm going to do that with this. Blend it in and up. And up. Just take my finger. Just to blend out the very, very edges. Alright, so middle color. Back to this brush, and I'm going to use, actually I'm just going to go straight for the middle of the palette and use that one. I'm going to put this one right in there. Notice how I just like plop it on, like this. I go over all of the rest of what I just did, kind of blend those two colors together closer to the edge. And out. Alright, and I'm going to use my finger really on this last color, which is that pink. And I'm going to pop that. Oh, that's really, really shiny, if y'all can see that. You can kind of see it. I'm going to pop that in the corner and on the highlight. Beautiful. Alright, so next thing I'm going to do is some detailing. So I'm going to take that brush I used for blending, clean it. I'm going to use this LA Colors eyeshadow palette with the black, just because it's the only black that I have left. Good. I need my mirror. Alright. And I'm just going to hit that crease that black again. And here's the other one. Alright. I'm just grabbing some more of that pink I put in the corner. Just to blend it in more. And put them underneath. Alright, so next I'm going to be doing my white eyeliner and my black eyeliner. I love liquid eyeliner. This is my favorite so far. It might not be the best for you because of the way this brush is, but I love this brush, how it has like a little dot on the end. I feel like it gives me a little bit more control over where in the product. So I'm going to pull down and just go ahead and line the inside. Good. And then I'm going to use my black eyes. Eyeliner and just line it off the edge. Yeah, I started in the middle. I don't try to do one swoop because you really can fuck it up like that. Oh. I'm really excited to show you guys this wig. I'll be doing a video soon on how I got it so straight. Considering it's a synthetic wig, I used a clothes steamer thingy with some little conditioner right before, just to get it to smell good. It really didn't need conditioner because it's a synthetic wig. How's that look? Good enough. I'm gonna use this little brush and that really dark color on my naked palette and just go underneath. Good. Same thing on the other side. Alright, I feel like we should pop some lashes on real quick just to really set the eyes off, and then we can start on my foundation. Be right back. Alright, so I'm back. I have my eyelashes and my eyelash glue. I got a new eyelash glue because I don't ever see them in black. I usually have to get hair glue because I really like the fact that they're in black. But is this backwards? I think so. Camera's like switched around, tripping me out a little bit. Alright, so I'm gonna put a little bit of glue on there. And let that get tacky. I'm gonna just set it down while I get some glue for the other side. By the time I'm done putting my glue on this side, that one should be tacky enough to apply on my eye. Alright, so I got my glue on this one. I'm going to set that one over there. I'm going to set this one on my eye. So I tilt my head back. So that I can see my eyelids. I put it directly on my eyelid. Alright. not a huge difference, but it's enough because of the fact that I'm going to use this other one too. Lid back on my glue, and let's get our mascara. Give me 1 second to find my mascara. Alright, so I got my mascara. Finish up these eyes and get to work on this face. Now, since we're going to be putting on blonde hair, alright, my eyes are done. Let's get started on my face. As always, I'm using 2 different color foundations to kind of do our under contour look. I'm going to use one little bit just because we're doing it. We're going to be doing light hair, that white hair. We're going to put a little bit in here and a little bit in here. Let's get our second color. And do all the stuff we did not just do. So, in here. Under here, and up here, also a tiny bit right here. Same thing on the other side. And a tiny bit in the middle. I know I look crazy. My hair is starting to stick to my makeup, actually, so I'm going to put this all back. I'm gonna need to put it back anyway when I put my wig on. So get our beauty blender, blend all this out. I always do the dark parts first so that my highlight stays highlight. I'm going to use the opposite side to do the highlight. I'm going to go over with a loose powder, Maybelline New York translucent powder in 02 medium. I'm just going to use this brush, really get it on there, and then tap most of that right off. kind of clear, you don't really need to highlight contour now in your powder. Sorry, I got a little bit of glue on my eyelid. Can't really tell. Alright, so lip, and then we're done. So for the lips, I'm going to be using a very cheap 22 eyeshadow and 72 eyeshadows, 24 lip palette. I don't know who it's by. I don't remember where it came from. So, since we're doing the white hair, let's go ahead and with some light gold. And I'm going to go with the white. So anytime I do lip gloss or lipstick, it's so, like, chunky. So I... Alright. So, let's get this wig on. Alright, so we're going to put the wig cap on. I just took a wet nap and went over my forehead area and cleaned off any makeup that's really close to my hairline up here, because I'm going to be wearing a lace front wig. I cannot wait to do this video to show you guys exactly how I straighten this wig. It's amazing. Alright, so anytime I wear lace front wigs, I like to have them glued down just because they're not really that, they don't stay down for me, personally. Alright. So, in order to glue this wig down, what I'm going to do is I tighten the back clips. You guys can't. Alright, well, there's a black, two little straps here. I tighten both of those. And I put my back clip in first. And then line up where my hairline is going to be. And I flip it. Just like that. See how it's upside down right here for right now? So I'm going to use some of that same glue and just stay out of my hair, but go around. I'm going to take this top clip and put that one in. Side clip, put that in, make sure you don't, like, clip in the glue to your hair, just be conscious and careful of that. So once that's done, I get real close to the lace and push. Feels like it's on there pretty good. I'm gonna let that sit for another second, and let me go get a hairbrush and change, and be right back. Alright, I just went and changed, got my hairbrush, I'm gonna brush this out. I think it looks good. Now, since I am wearing a lace front, I mean, I could leave my hair like this, but I feel like you're wearing a lace front, you're wearing a lace front because you want people to really get into the hair gig, so you want to, like, tuck your hair to the back behind your ear so that that hairline, they can clock. Well, they won't be able to clock it, but they'll be able to peep that shit and be like, oh, gorgeous, that's clearly growing out that bitch's head. Be right back. Alright, so that is the look. Let's see if I can get a couple of these little hairs to really come down through here. Get a couple of these little hairs, separate them so they go forward while everything else goes back. Give myself a little body. So that's the look. And that's the hair. And this is the makeup. And I hope everybody enjoys. I hope you hit the like button and comment below. Tell me how fucking gorgeous I am. Check me out on Facebook. That's Jessica Ariel Maldonado. That's it. I love you guys.